Now this state machine can be represented in the digital system as here, where X is the external input, output is Z, A and B are the state variables which will give us states S0 to S3 as mentioned here. Clock. The clock is very much required because the clock triggers the transition and the input determines the transition state. For each clock pulse, the input is checked whether the external input X is equal to 0 or X is equal to 1. Depending on that, we will move the states from S0, S1, S2 or S3. Whatever the conditions are specified. Now, but there is a point. If X is equal to 0, the S0 state will remain in S0. But if X is equal to 1 is applied, S0 will move to S1 when the clock triggers. So by the time clock triggers, the circuit have to remember what is the previous state, that is nothing but the S0. To remember this, two flip-flops are required. These two flip-flops will store the values for A and B, that is nothing but the state, as S0 corresponds to A is equal to 0 and B is equal to 0. Here is the diagram for generalized state machine. How actually state machine looks. So there you can see external input or inputs you can provide. You can provide number of inputs which are group of X, and there is an external output or external outputs. You're supposed to have many outputs if you design a state machine like that, having many multiple outputs. So there is a combinational logic circuit in between to which we provide an present state as A and B. So these are called as the present state, whereas after the combination logic circuit, clock pulse is given to the flip-flops, the combination logic circuit processes A's and B's to give us next state that are nothing but A plus and B plus. So you can call it as next state. So flip-flops DA and DB, they are required to store the values for the states, that is nothing but S0 to S3 as we have seen in the earlier section. So clock is required for triggering the flip-flops. You can see there are external inputs provided to the state machine. But till date we have studied the counters. Here is an example for 2-bit counter sequentially going from state 1 to state 2, state 2 to state 3, state 3 to 0 and 0 to again state 1. In this sequential circuit, we have arrows which don't have the input conditions as we have in the state machines. Means X is equal to 0, X is equal to 1. This type of external conditions are not provided in a counter to get its next state. Next point is there are no external inputs. That's what I talked about. X is equal to 0 or X is equal to 1 or any other external input to trigger the counter is not there, and no external outputs also. So this is how there's a difference between a counter and a state machine, though there are both are the sequential circuits. So that's all about the state machine. And the next session we will see about Millet and Moore machines, which are type of the state machines depending upon the outputs. Thank you.